opening intro of Tomb Raider 1 is just, I've seen it over and over again to the point where I just want to, like, die. So yeah, I would just go to the bridge. If you want, you don't have to. Sorry, guys. I don't know what's going on tonight. We did okay, though. We made it, like... We did it, like, 30 minutes. Oh! Have a good one, guys. Alright, do you guys... We're back on, though. We made it back. We did it. Cool. Super neat. I love it. Yeah, just, you know, you can probably... Are there any horror movies that you like that are considered kind of lame? For me, it is the Wishmaster movies. Any horror movies I like considered kind of lame? You have to walk around those things. No, the... what, horror movies that are lame? I mean, there's definitely horror movies that I used to think were very scary that are no longer scary. When I was a kid, I legitimately liked Troll 2, which is considered one of the worst movies ever. Like, I thought it was great. Mm-hmm. You're good. You did it. And there are... Turn around. There are more. And then that. You weren't here when I did that, so there's no reason. But this was the one part where you walked away and I played in the other part. So this is what you have to do. You have to light those up, and then that thing will light up now. Yeah.
On fire.
Huh?
On fire.
Event Horizon, yeah. Event Horizon I saw in the theater, and I was like, no. Honestly, I just, sometimes when something's really tonally dirgy, like a movie or whatever, I just kind of, I don't know. It just bums me out, and I'm just like, this is just a bummer. Okay. But I want to go back and watch it again. Remember I saw Fight Club in the movie theater, not knowing what it was going to be, and that blew my mind open pretty hard. That was pretty cool. That Rushmore, had no idea what it was going to be, saw it in the theater, blew my mind. This is super cool.
I've never seen
the
city. This is
where I don't need it. Circle, if you do it in the perfect spot, you can activate them all at once. Oh, okay, cool. You can activate those by got that. You got that from my mumblings? Sorry, I was mumbling. I don't want to expect you to, you know, to nothing. No, Stack. Keep it coming.
No. Yes, please keep it coming.
She doesn't want me to help, but she wants you to help.
Yes.
Unbelievable. Unbelieve. So yeah, guys, I guess the internet seems to be cutting in and out, so if it does cut off, just refresh the page. We should be right back on pretty immediately. So, no matter what happens, we'll still keep going until 11, but we seem to be having some technical difficulties. I've had a lot of those lately in this apartment. Well, and then I read something, somebody was freaking out about Mercury being in retrograde and how that affects getting simple things done easily and makes every easy task difficult, and then Lexi said it especially affects technology, and now I have it in my head that, like, everything's fucked technologically right now. Oh, cool, it just went up again. Okay, nice. I didn't know if it did or not. Cool. This really is, like, I'm glad, too, because that's what I'm pretty sure Flower is like that. In fact, I'm pretty sure Flower is even less of a game. This is a game, like, but flowers even more like, I think, meditative and just kind of chill. So I was hoping that, you know, this would be this kind, that kind of experience. Breathing it in. Hey, what's up, Brings Knives to Gunfights? How you doing, buddy? How's your shit? We are playing Journey on Legolugge Night.
Whoops.
It's very peaceful. Cool. So Bummer, your buddy left. Okay, so I guess I can talk about it now since the buddy just kind of dipped out. That's a real person. Your buddy.
What do you mean?
It's a real person. Maybe this is a real person too, I don't know.
What do you mean?
Like it's a real player.
How did they? Why?
It's a real player.
No, it's not.
Yeah. At least that is what I am under the impression that it is. So I guess
how
that
can somebody come in and do that?
So I guess that thing's gonna guide. Well, I mean, how do I play Overwatch with people all night?
Oh, so they. But.
Well, it's. I'm guessing maybe when you beat the game, it allows you to go help somebody else through their journey. Yeah.
I see. Okay, that makes. Thank you. That makes more sense.
I mean, I'm assuming. Like, I don't know because I've never played the game, but I've heard about the buddy thing. Which is kind of cool, but it kind of sucks that they just sort of dipped out on you.
Okay, I wasn't trying to follow them. Maybe that's why.
And you know, the gears, real person randomly connects people. It's cool, so it's like your little guide. Real person randomly connects people in similar areas. Oh, okay, cool. Oh, okay, that's what it is. It randomly just connects other people. That's kind of awesome. Ooh!
I'm on a carpet!
Are you controlling it, or...?
Oh, give it back. Come back to me. Come here.
1 minute there, then gone. This game is deep. Absolutely, Weed Assist. Yeah, dude, you should get it and play with your lady, man. I think she would enjoy it. And I'm kind of really enjoying Lexi being at the helm of this one. I'd prefer it. I think I would get too restless if I was playing this alone, but it's, like, really enjoying just kind of, in, like, chilling with Lex while she plays. You can team up with another player on your first playthrough. Okay. Interesting. They just kind of pieced. Oh, okay, so you can light those things up. Oh. Those little statues.
Yep.
Good instinct. Where'd those little floaty things go? Dapiak? I think it's Dapiak. I love this. Though I do wish I was about 100% more baked right now. Yeah, the style is gorgeous. Lex, what do you think?
Oh, no, I...
What's your honest review at this point?
I like it.
Oh, Dapiak or Dapiak? I always said Dapiak. Like, no diggity, no dap. Cool. Sparklies. Oh, to the right, it looks like. Wait, this is very correct. get your things back. Where's your little guides?
Right here.
I think, is it that you light them up to get them to continue to, like, guide you? Down, right? Oh, nice. That thing.
That's why they were right there circling.
Nice. Now they're moving on. Cool. Cool. You did the thing they wanted you to do. And now we continue with our journey. He read it in a book. So he's never heard. What book? He's never heard it pronounced. Need me to make it in there?
Scratch.
Why do you think you got acid reflux, honey?
The tomato sauce, and then I drank some wine all the fast. You don't need. Can you scratch?
Huh?
Scratch up.
There.
Up.
Sounds like Eastern European name, to be honest. Yeah, you know what, we just is, and it's only gonna take like 15 minutes. I mean, that's the funny thing about me. I'll put off getting a haircut. I have a Polish barber, lives right around, or no, they're Greek. Used to be Polish back when I was in my other neighborhood. They live right around the fucking corner from me, and I put off getting a haircut, and it's literally something that takes me 10 minutes. I can do it on the way to anywhere or home. See you guys play Hyper Light Drifter. Ooh, are they caged? Something tells me it's something scary.
Yeah.
It looks like you can walk across, yeah. Maybe turn around before you do that? Yeah, looks like you can jump across here, but I would probably turn around the camera, you know, before doing something. What's that? Yeah, go to that. Oh, it's another guy. It's a buddy.
Hi.
Hey, buddy. Yay, buddy. So funny. All right, cool. You got a buddy. You want to go back up where you were. You just want to do something different than what you did.
He's right here.
Well, who knows what he's... For all you know, it's just some, you know, mentally challenged kid or something, you know, like an after-school program. That's funny. You used up all your juice. Yeah, see, he's going that way.
Challenge.
Read it in the book Crow Killer, part of the name Depiak. Huh, cool. My name comes from how I'd smoke weed all the time before doing anything, so instead of was just... Whoa, do what he did. Yay! No, I'm gonna... Yeah. Nice. Cool. How cool is that, honey?
Cool.
Alright. What are y'all doing?
I don't know.
We just run across. I'm basically 13. Yeah, we just... I hear you, buddy.
Well, there's a train on the tapestry.
I don't know. Looks like you're stuck. Oh, they're all collected in there. Stuck again. So that thing picks you up and takes you?
Yeah.
Super cool. Yeah, light him up. Good stuff. So I think that's how many, like, light things you get in each level. Oh, you gotta go sit on it, honey. Cool. You did it with a buddy. That's fun. Crushing this game. Yeah. You're doing great. Oh, what's up, Not Evil, Not Free? This game is that anyone can randomly jump in anytime. I know, it's so cool. Oh, okay. I guess that's a train. I don't know if it's actually a train. It looks to be like some kind of power thing, powering things. I don't know, though. Yeah, super cool. That's how gamer tags work. Yeah, you're stuck. Yeah, it's kind of funny. I was thinking about that earlier, actually, my whole situation with all the different usernames that I have and everything. But I also just feel bad because, I don't know, maybe it's just in my head, but I feel like Holdenator's Ho, and we do Lexi Loves Game Night, so that people think
I'm
that...
Ho.
Yeah, like I'm saying Holdenator's Ho is Lexi, which is not true. I'm just saying that's what all my fans say. All my fans say Ho, right? So that's how we make it happen, you know? That's why I'm scared of switching to Deadglass. Design. I'm so used to Weedus Society. I bet. Yeah, I hear you on that. It would freak me out. I would know exactly who you were in an instant if you switched to Deadglass Design, but still. By the way, Deadglass Design. I think all you have to do is type in Holdenators. You get 50% off. Go visit their website now. This episode brought to you by Deadglass Design. Cool. How do you feel about your journey thus far?
Ooh, I'm really digging the sparkly sand.
Oh, cool. You're like skating on the sand. Lexecutioner is the best gamer tag ever. Too bad she just does. Title, it's Holdenator's Ho brings you Lexi Loves Game Night. Deliver the Indian. Hashtag deliver the Indian. Oh man. Why do I look clean for once, Not Equal, Not Free? What do I usually look like just disgusting? Oh, I gotta change my life. This is the first time apparently I look clean on the stream, Lex. I did go on a run, and I showered afterwards.
That's why.
Spick and span. I'm using a new face lotion scrub, so maybe that's what it is. Just the Dove. It's not the exfoliant, it's just the different kind that I like the smell
of
it better.
Some of the stuff that I
use. You did? I do use it. I use
it on
my ass, because you said I had breakouts on my ass.
Oh, hi.
Hey, you got a buddy. Non-gate 2016. Make the songs. You look like how the universe would perceive the perfect human, Holden. Don't listen to the haters. Thank you, Weedusis. Weedusis always has my back. Maybe it's because I plug Deadglass Design all the time. This episode brought to you by Deadglass Design. Go on their website and type in the code word Holdenators. Get some percentage off of the wonderful wares that they got going on over there. Do you want some sort of bones situation? Fucking get that shit at Deadglass Design. I was wondering, with the Cowmen, how did you guys decide on country music? Well, it's kind of a funny thing. Like, Doug Austin's grandfather is a country singer. We did blackout into the advert again. Oh, God. What was I gonna say? We ended up on country music. Doug Austin's always come from country music. That's what he was always born to play. His grandfather was a famous-ish country singer. He wrote a song called Apartment Number 9. Gate of Seth, what's happening, buddy? Ho! Everyone's doing fucking great, man. I'm glad you could join us. I wrote the song Russia Town on a lark. I was just fucking around with my guitar. I brought it to rehearsal one day for Murderfist. Yeah, Russia. Oh, for sure. It wasn't a Cowman song. It was just a song I wrote when I was fucking around. And then I played it before Murderfist rehearsal, and Ed liked it a lot. It caught his ear. And he essentially brought me together with Doug to start writing music together. So it's actually thanks to Ed that Cowman started. Cool. Gotta hang a boy there. Yeah. That's it. That's the story. I'm sticking to it. Where are you going? Follow your buddy. I think your buddy knows what's going on. But it's your journey. I love the look of the sand. The sun. This is what?
I can't get over how gorgeous this is.
Beautiful, absolutely beautiful. This is a winner of many awards. This is
Really?
Oh yeah, that's why I was so pleased, because I had not yet played it, and I was so pleased that it was free on PSN, because it's a game I'd always been meaning to play, and I thought to myself, this would be perfect for Lexi Loves Game Night. It's an indie game known for its beauty and wonderful sort of like wordless storytelling and all of this, you know? Whoa! Super cool.
Can I kiss my
Was it he was incarcerated for trying to make love to the moon? You can't make love to the moon? Yes, it is, Sweet Assist. Those are the lyrics. Lord Gold, 1 million. What's happening? New Cowman album? I'm not sure. We are currently recording the second song on the new album, and we are currently still writing new songs, so I really couldn't tell you when the next Cowman album is going to come out, because honestly, it's still a major work in progress. But I will say that we are recording and are having a great time with it, and we'll continue to write more music. We just wrote, we just had a big, wonderful creative night the other night. Felt really good about it. So what's going on here? You went all the way up there, but then you just fell down?
Okay. I gotta see where I'm going. That's my problem.
Best indie game for free. Fuck yeah, the Thunder Plug. I agree. That whole first Cowman album drew me a picture of a really interesting and messed up town. Yes, it was all supposed to be sort of a... That's the problem, is you gotta be pointing in the direction of it so you can see. Oh, still might take you up there. Oh. It's a horror musical, yes! Is it true you're more lizard than man? Absolutely, Lord Gull. How do you think I've been able to, you know, become as wealthy and successful with a beautiful woman as I have at this point in my life? Easily, from my lizarding. So I would turn around first, so that you don't see. Now you're going to be confused again. See what I'm saying? So like, walk over there, and before you do the bubble, turn around.
Mm-hmm.
Turn the camera around.
I know. You're right.
Rock opera from hell. Fantastic. These are all great things being said about the Cowman. Cool.
Okay.
You got this. Why are you
going
that way?
I'm not. I'm trying to go back down.
Here, good. I think it's like a card.
Really?
Oh, that's here. See? Like a car steering wheel.
I know that.
Then what's the problem? There you go.
Okay.
There it is. Just do it. You got it. Did you guys beat FF7? Yes, we did. You can go find a look at the archives on Twitch here or on YouTube. I have it all up. I also isolated just the Lexi Sephiroth fight, so you can look that up on the highlights page on Twitch, or you can go to YouTube where I also archived it.
I've already done this.
No, this is new. This is more of it. Ooh. He plays the neck lumps like an ocarina. Good times. Alright. This is different, right, than the one you did? It's the same?
Maybe. I don't remember.
Hype! Also catch me on Hype. I do a daily show called The Game Guru. Hype is in beta. Hype will, for some of you got the invite, check it out if you have an iPhone. I should have fucking made sure everyone had an iPhone. I didn't realize it was only for iPhone. It's in beta, but it will be coming out in a few weeks in the public. No, yes, it's just a hiatus. We're still meeting every week and writing. Oh, am I grabbing my penis? Ooh, awesome. I love this. Oh, the neck ocarina thing. I was worried because the other day someone called me out for grabbing my junk too much on stream, and I was like, because it's just a nervous tic I have. Is me talking about that ruining this beautiful moment for you, Lexi?
Yep.
This is amazing. Yeah, that was my mistake, weed assist. This is amazing. I'm like speechless right now, guys. This is super fucking cool. I love what they did with the lighting here. Oh, it's getting dark and creepy. Yeah, it looks incredible. Totally do that, especially when I'm stoned and wearing basketball shorts. Yeah, I just grabbing at it. I don't even know why. Shard does that really? Yeah, I'm talking about my shard from the Jersey Shore shard. The Jersey Shore shard. That's a good band name. Hey, we're the Jersey Shore shards.
You didn't shart. You just, I hope, right?
Am I ruining the beauty? Yep, no pause. Lexi's brutal. Man.
He just sets me up so easily.
I know. So good. And it's 10 o'clock, which means it's time for me to open up a bottle of wine. You want a refill, baby?
Yes, please.
All right, I'll be back, but you got to entertain these guys while I'm gone.
Oh, God.
Talk about your...
Hey, now I'm looking at you from behind you. No, who's terrible?
Yeah, it was so bad. That's a rough one.
Roundtable episodes. Did you ever discover who really cracked the tub? No. Not equal, not freezes. Torbjorn from Overwatch.
Torbjorn. You know Torbjorn. He's the one that built the turrets.
sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off like that. All the cowmen can do an EDM spinoff called the Jersey Shore Sharks. You didn't shart then, right? It was just a wet fart?
No, it was just a wet fart, but that's kind of a shart.
Oh, that's disgusting.
I didn't full-blown shit my pants, if that's what you're asking. I think that's what you're asking. No, I did not.
Did you wipe and there was, like, business there?
Do I have to answer this question?
No, but just know where my mind is.
Maybe.
Save me from it.
It was a long time ago.
No, it wasn't. It was so recent. It was way too recent. All right, I have to go back to this. Thank you.
How great is the soundtrack, Lexi?
I'm going to start packing cloths, like, with you when you go.
Yeah, for sure.
To your, like, in your
wet
little...
Wet towelettes.
Yeah.
Well, usually that doesn't happen, but we were brutally hungover on, like, 4 hours of sleep. In the hot sun during the middle of a Jersey Shore summer. So, can you light those up? No, right? I wouldn't think so. Yeah, I think you're good to move on.
Okay, I'm taking a Zantac.
Yeah, because you're having a hard time. Well, you know, what's good for acid reflux is drinking more wine, so.
Good, because that's what I intend to do.
Hey, what's up, Edweb? How you doing, man? It looks like right now I'm playing Journey, but that's not true. I'm just filling in while Lexi gets his Zantac. Oh, something's happening, though. Maybe I shouldn't have done anything.
Oh, if anybody is in the New York area tomorrow, come to the pit at 7 p.m.
Lexi's doing comedy tomorrow night at the pit, 7 p.m. Be there, be square. I'm pretty sure every single person who watches this, except for like one or two people, are from all over the world.
I know. But I like it that way, the all over the world way.
Oh, yeah, me too. I wouldn't trade it for the world. Go. Well, we'll see. Eventually.
Take my Zantac, put some wine.
Eventually, if we can one day get enough people to watch us play video games, and a much smaller percentage of those people to give us money, we will we'll buy a new couch with it so that we can continue to stream comfortably for you guys. God, I would really love to be streaming more often, though. I hope that that'll become a reality soon. Just get a few more of those Kotaku gigs. We are not set to do that yet. I would love to, though. Maybe I'll talk to Marcus about it, because DC wouldn't be that hard for the Cowman to do. It's all just logistics and shit. It's way harder to get a band to a place to play a show than it is to get three dudes who do a podcast. Like, you gotta deal with so much shit. The drums and all the bullshit. I love this area. I keep saying that about every area, but I love this. Hold them, we're getting Kissel to confess to the tub shitting. You know what? If you can get that to happen, get it on video, you know, it'll blow my mind, but I just don't know. I don't think there is getting Kissel drunk enough to confess to something like that. He's very good. He's a very good drunk.
Yeah.
So you have to understand about him. He's huge. He can hold alcohol like nobody fucking knows. You need like a straight up truth serum, not just alcohol. They are in there, but you already have enough. You've already filled your little scarf. Hey, is that DB Golden Banana episode of Roundtable? Fuck, I missed that one. All right. Podcast needs to include Kissel's writer, which includes shitting and tubs. You should come down regardless. I think I might be able to afford to buy you a drink. Fuck yeah, man. I would love to.
That new scar. See, I'm glad.
How can Kissel to confess where he put the bodies of the victims. You know, yeah, the whole Kissel serial killer thing, I just block out because you guys freak me out with that talk.
Yeah. His girlfriend is lovely.
His girlfriend, he has a lovely girlfriend, guys.
Very pretty.
Way out of his league.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a little shiny thing in there, so maybe you can, like, jump up to it.
Like
it. Oh, he's getting it. You have a buddy.
Oh, buddy!
Wait, turn around. Yeah, jump up. Jump up in there.
Whoops.
You way too far. You don't have to hold it down all the way if you just wanna.
Wait,
yeah.
There we go.
And then.
Hi.
Make your scarf longer.
I didn't see it.
Is his girlfriend alive or is she a mannequin? Dahmer style, she kind of looks like a mannequin. She's blonde, she's very pretty.
Yeah.
She's very sweet. Young.
Tall.
But doesn't seem too young.
Doesn't seem too young. How old is she? She's probably like...
She's like 12, 13.
Times two! No, yeah, she's like...
Yeah, something like that.
23, 24 or something.
Oh. DB Golden Banana in Massachusetts or nah? DB Golden Banana. I'm not sure. You want to do a big jump like your buddy did.
I have to see what's in the darkness.
Baby. Fucking cold here. Oh yeah, it's winter. Today was. How
cold does it get?
I felt like today was essentially like the first day of.
Yeah, it was actually really nice today.
It was gorgeous today.
How cold does it get in Australia?
Good question, Lexi. We assist, how cold does it get in Australia? So you can't jump, so you used it. What's the fastest land mammal? That's another good question. Weedasis, what's the fastest land mammal?
Cheetah.
Oh, those things light up, huh?
Yeah.
And you float in those?
Yeah.
I bet there's little ticket things in the tube.
Okay. A little tube. Here's my friend.
So you probably want to climb up those things to get to the top.
Oh.
Oh, he gave you things. So now you can...
Oh, no, I got things with the...
Oh, okay. So now you can, like, float on... that, yeah, and that'll float you up, I think.
Probably. Oh.
Well, you have to stay in them.
Hmm.
Now you're in the thing.
I know where I am. Guys.
Turn around. Get on the thing.
I'm being a child.
Float up the thing. I mean, if you need me to just help you, if it's some simple thing like this, I can just help you. I don't know what you're supposed to do per se, but I think it's a camera angle situation as usual. Yeah, see how he's getting way up there? That's what you need to do. I bet you can hold X and float up to the top. Yeah, you can float up to the top. So go to that one and float up to the top, and then you can get up there. Yeah, to the plank.
Oh, I went over. Ooh.
Yeah.
That's okay. All right, I see now.
You got it. You know how to do it?
Yeah.
So it's really best show concert you've ever been to. I'm gonna say. My best concert. I've talked about it before on here, but it was probably the Flaming Lips of Bonnaroo. They came down in a giant spaceship. They threw out 10,000 laser pointers into the audience. I was tripping on mushrooms, and it was a great time. It's the camera angle, honey. So if you point it like that so you can go forward when you do it, then you'll be able to do it. See, because then you have perspective and you can see. See, and then you can float up in there. Yeah. There you go.
I mean, I would have figured that out.
Beautiful. Well, honey, I think most of the times with your gaming situation, it's always camera angle.
It's a situation.
It's always adjusting the camera angle in connection to your movements. What's your favorite concert or show you've ever been to, Lexi? Super cool. This part's super cool. Do you have one? It could be a play or something.
Oh.
If you want it to be a play. All he said was show or concert, so.
In terms of, like, music, I think maybe, come back to me.
No, keep going. Don't worry about him. That's where you gotta go. Can you die in this game?
Am I underwater?
Yeah, it looks like it. Yeah, because that was like seaweed, which is kind of funny. Yeah. That's what I thought it was before. What were you going to say?
I think... God. It's really hard.
What's a show that you liked a lot?
Ani DiFranco. Of course.
The recent one?
Yeah, that was pretty great. And then also,
The Les Miserables live musical was an experience.
When I was... about 9 or 10, I saw Jesus Christ Superstar.
And that like blew your shit open?
Like, I cried. I was like so emotional about it. And then this makes me sound like a huge musical theater nerd, and I'm really not. I'm not like somebody that just like
listens
to musical theater. But as a kid, there were certain musicals that I feel like I need to go in there.
Yeah, no, go forward. Go for it.
Okay.
I was wondering what was going on. I'm like, why did you get that? Whoa. One more day.
Yeah,
I went
then
to the 2009
like
Gathering of the Juggalos. It was five smelly days of cheap drugs, dirty naked fat chicks, good times. I've always wanted to go to a gathering, Ed Webb, so maybe we'll have to go with you sometime. Anyways, you were saying, Lex?
When I was 14, 13 or 14, I saw Rent. And then, you know, just the things, the rock opera type things, I really...
That stuff's great. I really enjoyed seeing Tommy live. We just, by the way, says he was a stage manager for production of Jesus Christ Superstar.
Love Jesus Christ Superstar.
Probably my favorite musical I've ever seen live was Book of Mormon.
Really?
Yeah. And probably my favorite musical.
I'm gonna go with Hedwig.
Yeah.
Recently, Hedwig.
Yeah.
That was an event.
Yeah. Also, probably my favorite musical of all time is South Park: Bigger, Longer, and Uncut. Keep going towards the there. Are you just having fun with the guy? Okay, have fun with the guy. Sorry. This is my problem. I'm too objective-oriented. That's why, like, why I have such a hard time with games of this nature. I'm just like, get to the end, get to the end. It's like, why?
We're
it's
friends.
Just here.
We're
yeah,
because we repower each other.
You're there to be buddies and stuff, and I'm like trying to keep you from enjoying your buddy, and that's really dumb and lame. Your buddy has a longer scarf, got more secrets. We need to organize a gathering of the Juggalos, of the Naders, at the next
Naders,
Juggalo
yeah.
Festival. Holy shit, would I
that
love
would
to do that. And I'll get Marcus to come. That would be so much fun, man. Gathering of the Naderlos. Dude, if we could pull that off, I would fucking love
it. Naderlos!
Naderlos, yeah. What's the best makeout movie Lord Gold asks? I love Lord Gold's fucking throwing out the questions like this. This helps. Lex loves Game Night Booth at the Gathering. The best makeout movie? That is a good question. Because, I mean, you know, it's got to be the kind of thing where it's just kind of happening there in the background. I wonder if, like, Dazed and Confused is the best makeout movie. Because it's just a movie you've seen, like, a million times.
Yeah, it is. I definitely made out to it.
See? So I'm not incorrect. Not with me.
No.
Unbelievable.
I was in eighth grade.
What's another good, maybe, what's a good makeout movie, honey? Maybe a musical movie would be.
Grease? Because you can ignore it?
Yeah, if you can just ignore it. Call to Make Love to Me. Professor Placenta, I don't know if that's possible with the lady here. Oh!
He was trying to help me get out of the way!
What happened? Follow your buddy. Your buddy's out trying to help you. There's where your buddy's going. A Serbian film or Human Centipede? Absolutely, Bjorn. The Exorcist. Any of the Austin Powers movies? That's a good one because it's kind of sexy, it's funny, you've seen it a million times. Love Actually is a very good one.
Love Actually is kind of
I'd probably say, you know, my big date movie was always you lost your scarf power.
Yeah.
Big date movie was always Annie Hall. That was always the one I threw on for dates. Manhattan's another good makeup movie. But apparently, oh no. I think you want to stay out of that light.
Oh no, I hit the light.
Yikes. This game got scary and mean. Probably need professional help. Sorry, you can make up. That you need to be castrated. Yeah, definitely Bjorn. I would seek professionals. Maybe see what's in the tube, but definitely probably want to keep it moving.
In the tube?
No, don't worry about it. Yeah, I would go to the right, maybe. Yeah, follow. At the end of the day, you always just follow your guy. Where's he going now? See, he's going into the tube. He had the same idea I had. Across the Universe. I've never seen it. Yeah, because it's kind of seems like it might cheese me out, but you know, I'll give it a shot if you say it's good.
Oh.
Nothing in there.
I don't know where I am.
I think it's just a good way to hide from the monster. It's like a big penis and balls. There you are.
Ah.
There you go. again, all in the camera.
It is a big
piece. You want me to help you out?
No.
Here.
Why?
Okay, don't move the camera. Run to the right. And you're up. Last time I made out to a movie was Resident Evil Apocalypse, simply because the lady I was with got bored. See, that's the thing. You want a boring movie. You want a not good movie. Panic Room I got to make out during, because it just was not doing it for us. Don't go back in.
Why?
Why wouldn't you? Because you got stuck in there.
Because I'm trying to hide from the scary things.
Just... Well, there you go. I found a way to yell at you. I would turn left, and I think you want to go that way.
Here?
Like, past this. Don't go back in that thing. Jump across it. Not that way, to the right. That way. Boom! Yeah. Rock and roll, baby. You did it. Supporting role, Stripes. Leading role, Uncle Buck. Uncle Buck, perfect makeout movie. Wouldn't you agree? No?
I enjoyed Uncle Buck.
I think it's a great makeout movie, because you saw it when you were a kid, everybody's seen it. It's not going to be too gripping, it's just perfect for the background. Am I being an idiot about thinking about going to work while sick? I've done it a million times, you know. I like to call out sick when I'm perfectly healthy, and I like to go into work when I'm sick. Because it's work, so who gives a shit? I'm going to be miserable anyway, so I might as well be at work. Nice. Slide time. Whoa! Oh, you want to stay out of that light. Whoa! I don't know if you can stay out of that light. Cool, with your other journey person. That's kind of neat. Whoa! Super cool. Right. You beat another one. Getting stressed. I'm stressing out.
You're stressing me out.
I'm sorry. Don't worry about me. Don't worry. I just couldn't. You were stuck in the tube, and then you went back into the tube. I just didn't know why you would do that.
To hide from the thing. God.
I keep going to work sick as hell. I wouldn't call in sick until I can't get up from my bed. I should just get better.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You might, if it's been a while now, you may need to straight up rest just to cure yourself. Well, I apologize for getting frustrated with you. That's what this show's all about. It's about working through our issues and our troubles. Yeah? Huh?
Then Sephiroth appears in Jeremy. What do you do?
You cast
barrier
and
debarrier. And you do knights of rock, and then you mime it, and
your knuckles are bruised. Hanging out with your family and your in-laws. I can't see the rest of that comment, but it's very upsetting. I'm mad. Maybe you did a good thing. Yeah. I like Bjorn's response, even though I only got like half the comment. Maybe you gave vigorous hand time to the missus. It's a good knuckle bruiser.
Wow.
I mean,
that
bruising
is really
the knuckles is...
Professor Placenta.
Sure, Professor Placenta. I'll write it down right now.
That's a fantastic name. Sorry, I'm just noticing this.
Yeah, I even said it out loud earlier.
Yeah, I think, yeah.
I was surprised you didn't catch it.
I was tuning you out. Ooh, no, sorry.
Did you say the shout-out? Since today at the college, we're like, what happened? You should have to told them you brought a knife to a gunfight. There you go. Maybe you did that. Maybe you did your name.
It's a clever name.
It is a good name. I wonder why your scarf got nerfed.
It's because we got attacked.
You got hit by the thing? That's so mean that they would do that. Could you say, Jenna, Mark loves you and your weird butt. Thanks for the name compliments. Mark loves you and your weird butt. Jenna, Mark loves you.
Okay, so I gotta go up there.
I don't know, because I'm writing this comment down. Got it, buddy. Gate of Sethu, what happens if you bring a gun to a knife fight? You win the knife fight. Lexi and Ho, well, if it's a loaded gun. If not, then maybe you throw it at the guy and I don't know what happens. Lex and Ho, family reunion, my right hand is bruised. No idea what happened. Gotcha. No problem. Anytime. Any
cool.
Fucking time. Super
flying.
Cool. Super
flying.
Cool. They did it on Mythbusters. Maybe you hold down X and you'll fly higher. Ooh, get that.
Thank
you. Need a longer scarf at this point. Do I have a chance with Jackie? Like, if Doug were to disappear under mysterious circumstances? Yeah, I think if Doug were to disappear under mysterious circumstances, Jackie would become, let's say, very emotionally vulnerable. So yeah, I think, you know, pretty much anybody who sticks around long enough. I'm saying this only if Doug were to disappear under mysterious circumstances. She would be very upset. Ryan, 1961, have you ever played the Orange Box for PS3? Yes, we did. I think I played it on Xbox, though, not PS3. But yes, that's where I played Portal for the first time. We actually recently did a Wizard and the Bruiser episode about Valve, and I kind of relived those days because I played all of that shit for the first time on the Orange Box, actually. I did all of Portal, Half-Life 2. I never played Half-Life. And so I think you want to go to the left. You see where they're on the other platform over there?
I want that thing.
What thing?
That big light.
I think it's just a light.
Oh.
Yeah. You get Half-Life 2 and Episode 2 and Team Fortress 2 and Portal. I've never played Team Fortress 2 because we didn't have it hooked up to the internet, so that wasn't a thing. Yeah, see, it's just a light. Jack would probably be prime suspect. That's very true, Dapiek. So you want to float up, honey, and get on those platforms up there.
I was just here.
All right, now turn around to the... Not that way, but to the left. That's the platform. You want to get to that next platform. Yeah, yeah. You can just float over to it. Fly over with X.
Then I use up all of my... Oh, and I don't have anything.
Now you have more, so you can float up to it. If you don't get caught under it. Well, Team Fortress 2 has not been updated since release, so it's fairly outdated. Well, yeah, and now I'm playing Overwatch, so I would assume that would be more of a thing. I guess just get into that. Yeah, actually, you can float up on those. Yeah. Buddy's got your back. Buddy always has your back. If the Orange Box was remastered for PS4, would you buy it? Absolutely. Honestly, just to, you know, to have Portal again, and I'd like to give Half-Life 2 another go. That'd be cool. I'm one of those shitheads who was... just float. Turn around, there's all those seaweed things behind you. Yeah, go to that. I wasn't like super duper into it. I didn't do the Half-Life thing when it was groundbreaking, so. You can't float up those things?
No.
By holding down X? Yeah, you can float to the top of that surface by holding down X. And then light those things up by holding circle. Which I think your buddy's kind of doing it for you. one to the left that's higher. Yeah. Yeah. What if the orange box was literally a box of oranges? Well, I would enjoy playing that too. So following the trend, is anyone reading any good books lately? I'm still reading Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix. I'm trying to catch up with Lexi, who blew the fuck past me in the books.
So good.
Hi, friend. Also, a really good comic book. I read the first trade of it. I want to go get more, called The Manhattan Projects, which Marcus turned me on to. But it was when we were out in Baltimore, he was like, you should get this. We're at a comic book store. And it's great. It's assuming that The Manhattan Projects only existed as a cover-up for what was really going on in The Manhattan Projects. It was a higher-up seaweed than that one. Hold down X, honey. I think he lifted it up for you, so you're good. Look at that guy. Reading Dungeons and Dreamers, the history of computer games from Geek to Chic. That looks awesome. If you like awesome archaeology, adventure with guns, like a modern day Indiana Jones, read Matthew Rainey. Underground Airlines is great. Alt history where slavery is still legal. Nor as hell. Yeah, I would highly recommend the Manhattan Projects. Very cool. Very cool trade. Man, I tried to get inside that middle thing. Yeah, if you hit circle by the... Oh, what's up, John Robert Wilson? How you doing, buddy? Everybody, go check out the Unlimited Lives Twitch stream. They do Minecraft Mondays on Monday nights, so I guess you're done with that. But go check it out. They start at 8 p.m., so you can check them out and then hop over and watch Lexi play games like Journey.
Not well.
You're doing great, baby. Right now it's questionable, but I think you want to maybe go to that dragon and hit circle by him.
Do you know how many times I've done that?
Your buddy's doing it. Well, you gotta float up to him. So when you get under the surface there, your cape fills back up. Do you notice that? And then you can float up, which is where the dragon's at. See? How do I know if I'm a go-boy or a no-boy? Well, essentially, if you're down for fun, you're a go-boy, and if you hate fun, you're a no-boy. Yay, you lit up the dragon. I don't know what that does, but maybe just get on top of him. Yeah. Just hang on top of him. Oh, it's already lifted all the way up, so now you can float up to that higher-up surface by holding X. The Man in High Castle. I need to check that out. Looks fun. It's a platform behind you. Okay, he's lighting it up for you, so stop on that one. Okay, or he just made a bunch of bridges. Yeah. Your buddy is clutch in this one. By the way.
Oh, thank God, because I have no idea what's happening.
That's fine. We're moving. It doesn't matter. It's pretty, and we're moving. Unless you get caught in the thing. Right. Nice. We need to make reading sexy again. A quote by some guy I can't remember. I believe that quote is by John Waters. I believe he said, if you go to someone's house and they don't have any books, don't fuck them.
Yeah. I just finished Hunger Makes Me a Modern Girl.
Ooh, what's that all about?
Carrie Brownstein's
Slater
Kenny's story, mm-hmm. which was really, really good.
And Portlandia.
Good.
Saw y'all streaming, so thought I'd say hi. Crystal all. Says hi, headed back to her stream. Awesome. Hello, Crystal. Thanks for thanks for hopping on, man.
I'm learning how to use a camera controller thing. Bad at it. Anyway.
I'm going to try Star Trek later. I heard you can play that for free right now. Is this a video or are you just... I think you can go to the end of this level though, right up there. You can float to the top by holding down X. Like I've been playing this game for years now or something.
Yeah, like how do you know?
I know the two things you're able to do. You're able to create that bubble which affects the things around you, like so, and you're able to float. And so when you're just standing there or whatever, like hold down X to reach a higher place, especially if your cape is full of stuff. Yeah, your friend is the shit. Oh my God, your friend hooked it up, this level. Ah, Starship Troopers, so good. Love Starship Troopers. I feel like we have talked about Starship Troopers on like 8 different episodes of this exact show.
Really?
Yeah, we tend to bring it up a lot. Everybody on chat and myself included love Starship Troopers. I think we might have to do like a group viewing of it on here or something. Yeah, let me know what you think of Star Trek, man. Jared from Murder Fist is currently trying to dip his toes into it. I'm guessing you're talking about the Star Trek, like, online. Cool. Oh, with the buddy.
I know.
Has there ever been a Star Trek Troopers game? I don't know, but I would totally play it. I don't think there is. The game seems like really deep. I feel like I'm missing some grand truth that's been revealed. I know, right? He's just being weird. He's so good, though. Found secrets too, like how long his cape got. Yes, it was a PC game. Okay, there was a Starship Troopers on PC. That's amazing. We were just shown the nature of existence and didn't grasp it.
Yeah, that makes sense.
2005 first-person shooter game, Starship Troopers on PC. Somebody check it out, let us know if it's any good. Take a fat dab on stream. Yeah, I don't know if it's... I think from what I heard, you can get kicked off if you're doing something illegal. So if I can, you know, if I end up streaming from Denver anytime soon, which is always a possibility because my brother lives there, I'll absolutely do that. Also, I don't have the whatever you need to take dab hits.
What's
I don't even have like a
hit?
Bong. It's a very concentrated hit of weed. It's like the new thing. It just makes you retarded. Ruining the beauty with his sharks. And then now you're just dancing with your partner. I don't think those are a thing.
Trying to lose me?
No.
I mean, I would.
No, you're. I mean, he's carrying you. I love carrying people through stuff. I love escorting people through Dark Souls games.
Is this where we were? But now we're. This would be a really cool Halloween costume.
Mm-hmm. Agreed. I get close to your friend so you can... Yeah.
Oh! I get it. It's like warmth. Oh, that was me?
Lexa plays Dark Souls. When? Good question. As soon as it's out on PS4, I hope they do some kind of HD remakes. All I want to do on Lexi Loves Game Night is play through Dark Souls. But I'm not sure. I'm not sure if it'll ever happen. We may do a run through of Dark Souls 3, but it's just not the same. You know? I do kind of like this, though. Whatever we play next, I feel like if you want, we can do episodes where we take a break to play something peaceful, you know? So I think you might want to get behind those blocks. Maybe? Maybe? Lexi plays Postal, too. Favorite Demon Souls boss? Bloodborne? Unfortunately, I haven't played Demon's Souls. It's the only one I have not played. I will play it as soon as I can get my hands on it, but unfortunately... Actually, I could probably get it on PC. Is it on PC? I could probably get it on this PC. Ooh, I didn't even think about that. But my favorite Bloodborne boss... Oh, thanks, Nasty Norm. Fuck yeah, dude. My favorite Bloodborne boss... That's a really good question. It might be, what's her name? The last Vicar. Definitely the Orphan of Cause for the DLC. That boss is fucking incredible. And in the main game, it's, what's her name, guys? It's the first Vicar or whatever. Vicar Amelia. Wow, look at you. Damn, girl. Vicar Amelia. Lexi throwing out some Bloodborne names. Just weather through it, just push through it.
Right.
Oh. Yeah. Good work. Keep it going. I think you want to get either in front of or on the other side of those blocks.
That's what I'm trying to do.
I just read Looking for Alaska. Was it good? Yeah, I'm Kid Safe every Monday night, 9 to 11. We always do it. Yeah, Blizzard Effect's pretty cool. It's hard though, man. It's difficult. You're doing better than the other guy. Oh, sweet brings knives. Thank you. Fuck yeah, dude. Awesome. Helms Levi, what's up? First time here. What's happening, buddy? Good to see ya. We're trying to get our asses through this blizzard right now. In Journey on Lexi Loves Game Night. He's
yeah.
Got it.
Yeah.
Oh, but you're like pushing him away.
No, I didn't mean
That's all good. You got it. Keep going. Now y'all know the trick.
Well, yeah, that's what I was trying to do.
You gotta try to get to that one on the left. It's gonna be the next one. Oh no. It's gonna start picking up. Hey, have a good night, Final Fantasy King 9. What's up, man? Game night. It's Lexi Loves Game Night, every Monday night from 9 to 11. We're playing Journey tonight as her reward game for finally beating Final Fantasy VII 2 weeks ago. Of course, we took last week off. It's good to reintroduce the show. It's a radio thing, Lexi. You know? That's how they do it on the radio. You gotta, like, say the name of the show every now and again.
I'm all the way the fuck back here.
No, you're fine. You're fine, baby. It's all good. You're almost done. Push through there and I bet you'll be done. Giving you the bad advice. Yeah, this looks like new. Light it up. Can you not light it up? Yeah. I was like, I don't think you're... No, you can't light it up. Red Carl Sagan's Demon Haunted World, Science as a Candle in the Dark. Was it good? Is that your wife? It's my girlfriend, Lexi. Hi. Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah. So I'm Holden. I do a podcast and shit.
That doesn't.
Does Lexi really love game night, or is that just a nice tale my mommy told me? I'm gonna go with Lexi. Hey, what's happening, F1 Raid Ninja? Lexi loves game night. Maybe she didn't at first, but I think she truly enjoys it now, especially now that we're playing Journey. Yeah, Stockholm Syndrome.
You should explain the premise.
Do it every week. Lexi does not normally play video games. I love video games, so every week we play video games together, or she does, and I hang out and sometimes get
mad at me for not doing exactly what you want.
All right, okay. Unbelievable. If it was a podcast, you need to pimp Blue Apron, Audible, or Casper Mattresses. Well, right now we're pimping Casper Mattresses, apparently. That's the big new sponsor.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah. Or at least for the last podcast. We talked about them a lot on Roundtable as well today. Cool. You definitely made it to the next part.
Cool.
That's for sure.
So this show is a test to see if our relationship can survive.
Can make it through, and then maybe a ring will happen eventually. Baby.
It's never gonna happen.
What are you talking about? That's crazy talk. I'm all about Squarespace and their cheap advertising deals on podcasts. It's very true. I use Squarespace for my personal portfolio website, HoldenMcNeely.com. Highly recommend it. I really enjoyed it. You can tell I'm getting more like wine drunk.
Oh, we are friends. We are friends.
Yeah, that's your buddy.
I love him.
TVF, I have a Casper mattress. Not bad.
How is it?
So, Holden, you still listening to Super Friends Friendcast? Or Super Best Friend Cast? Yes, I am. I'm really enjoying it. Especially because they talk about Overwatch a lot, and I like Overwatch a lot. We're already acting married law. I subbed. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much, Helms Levi. Every Monday night we do this. I try to do streams in between when I can. For dead glass design. Nice. Nice. We just use Squarespace for dead glass. New Huffin' It win. Oh, man. Someday, man.
Oh, so
maybe
good.
Maybe someday.
I'm in the first episode.
What's this door being shut bullshit? You do yours? Yeah, come on. There must be some kind of thing you gotta go back and do.
You know, it's true.
Thanks, Bjorn. What now?
The journey is easier with a friend.
Yeah, oh, yeah. Journey is important. Roundtable is life. Yeah, Roundtable of Gentlemen is the podcast I do. I'm in a band called The Cowmen. Lexi's in a sketch comedy group called Boats. We got a lot of shit going on right now. So maybe some would say too much. Also write, I've written a couple articles for Dorkly, and I've got a little article in the works.
Babe, on Overwatch, who's your main?
I'm maining with, I go between Soldier 76 on offense, Junkrat on defense, D.Va as tank, and Zenyatta on support. How about you, Helms Levi? Still need to pick up a roundtable shirt. Yeah, we need to make them. I think we're gonna start making some Marcus just struck some kind of deal to start making like one off more like smaller amount of prints, but like what the fuck am I trying to say? Shirts that we don't print a ton of but are like specialty shirts. They have those? Not yet. I'm Kid Safe might make one. Nah, there's not round table shirts yet. So what's the deal here? You guys are just kind of...
wandering.
Maybe can you light those up?
Oh, we're going to get behind it. That's what I am doing. Oh, whoops. Maybe I shouldn't do that. Really?
Weird. Is this a new way?
Well,
then can you ask Marcus if they'll bring Last Podcast shirts to sell at the UK show? I'm sure they're bringing Last Podcast shirts to sell at the UK show. They bring Last Podcast shirts to every show.
They're going to the UK?
Yeah, they're doing UK in October, I think.
Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to push you.
Wait, that's the worst time to do it. it's kind of better that way. One in front and one behind. That way you can, like, share it better.
That's true.
He's ahead of you now.
Come back, friend.
You answered this already, but is this a new path?
I don't know.
I think it is. I think it has to be. Because you walk past all those little, like, weird grave things. 5th and 6th of October, yeah. Yeah, they'll definitely bring every single different of those t-shirts. My art before I make a proper... Yeah. I like your work, man. I dig it, I'm Kid Safe. It's good stuff. Tracer, Genji, Bastion, Law. I know. Well, man, Genji's impressive. I would like to be good with Genji. And Tracer, actually. Those are two of the main characters I wish I was better at because they look like a lot of fun to be good at. And whenever I watch competitive players play, they just rip it open as those characters. Yeah, man. So that's the way you came from, right? Didn't you walk past all these? And you can't light these up. No. I just follow that guy. Lucio all day, my friends. I might switch to Lucio and start working with him and on support. I really dig Zenyatta. I really like the Discord orb and the healing orb kind of situation. And being able to, you know, rip it open kind of like Lucio can. Yeah, for sure. Catcher6945 is my PlayStation Network tag, so hit me up. Yeah, I ordered mine about a year ago before they were doing the Patreon thing. Good call. That's about the t-shirts for last podcast. Cool moon. Took a solid few weeks. Yeah, I'm sure. Well, especially out to Australia, where we desist hails from. I'm a Mercy boy, says Dapiek. Yes, you are. Dapiek and I play all the time, and he rules as Mercy. Holy shit. Finished unlocking the last character features I wanted today, so I consider her complete. I just got a D.Va's emote where she eats the Doritos and plays video games, and I am loving it. Super enjoying that. I've only had the one glass of wine, but I'm feeling... Well, what? You have your own.
I know.
I just wanted a tasty taste. Love playing Tracer, says I'm Kid Safe. I'm Kid Safe. You're not on PlayStation, I take it. Took a solid few weeks. Oh, for the, t-shirts. Now I'm just reading old comments over again. Mm-hmm. So you guys did find somewhere new.
Yeah, I think so.
So I bought Overwatch after a stream here, but haven't played it because I'm not so great. Are you on PlayStation Brings Knives? Favorite fighting game, 2D or 3D? I'm going to go with 2D. You mean like which one on 2? 3D Tekken 3, 2D Street Fighter. I want to say 5, but they just kind of fucked up the whole, like, I love the fighting in it, but so I guess I'll have to say Street Fighter. Well, really, it's Street Fighter 2, if you're going to get down to it. Would probably be my favorite 2D fighting game. Maybe Street Fighter Alpha 2 might be up there.
Do you guys like to see Holden and I stream some fighting games?
Oh my god, are you serious? We can do that. We can do that next week. Of course, we can do whatever we want. It's our show. Whoa. Careful now. Yeah, you added me as a friend, I think. Okay, great. Well, let's play. Yeah. Add Dapiek, and we'll get on there, and we'll you know, hit me up to play with you anytime that I'm on there. I'll definitely bring you in, and we have a really supportive group. Nasty Norm on here is on there as Enormous Smash. He's awesome. Like, you know, it's a very friendly group that is happy to show someone the ropes. Lexi V. Holden, head to head. Yeah, we'll do that next week. I think we should do like a whole series of co-op and versus stuff.
Yeah.
Might not be good though. You'd have to drag me along. Yeah, but that's fine. Well, Dapiek and Enormous Smash and all those guys had to drag my ass along. It took me a couple sittings before I got the hang of it. The good thing about that game is they built it in a way so that if one person is, you know, not up to snuff or whatever, you can still win as a team. I mean, they designed it so brilliantly. I don't think there's any wins coming. Oh, there they are. Alright, we got about 5 minutes left here. Hopefully this level will finish up soon. It looks like it will. Looks like you guys kinda are getting to the apex. Having that acid reflex bad? Oh, okay. I thought you were grabbing your...
No, it's itching.
Oh, okay.
I was itching my up boob.
Yeah, I think Overwatch is like 50% more fun with people. In fact,
what?
Oh, okay, so you're gonna wanna get under those things. You're gonna wanna get under those things when he does that.
Oh, my scarf.
No scarf. You done? We'll be finishing this stream up. We'll be finishing up pretty soon, Helms. We usually go till 11. So hopefully we'll hit the end of this level here pretty soon. And then, yeah, we'll probably call it a night. But thanks so much for joining us, man. And, hey, we're not done yet. We're still fucking around. Have a good one, I'm Kid Safe. Thanks for catching it, man.
Yeah, have a good one.
Yeah, Lord Gold, if you have a PlayStation 4, you know, yeah, get in there. Get in there with him. If you have a PlayStation 4, you know, hit me up. Catcher 6945. We'll play together. Okay, hold on, Lexe. You are getting so close to the end here. Shame you don't have time to finish tonight. Probably about 20 to 30 minutes left.
Oh.
Ah, gotcha. Well, at least get to the end of the level. We'll see. I mean, where are you at, Lexe? You need to be done?
I mean...
Okay, cool, Lord, cool.
No. I'm sorry. I can't think.
So maybe that means...
Maybe.
That's fine, honey. I'm not the one playing. I'm just hanging out talking to chat, so it's entirely up to you. I would, yeah, stay in there. The only thing is, Dabiek, does this level end? Like, before the end, or is this it? Alright, you can probably pass now.
Rocket League!
Yeah, we should definitely do some Rocket League.
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure, we desist. We might do that on stream, actually. I was thinking about doing that earlier today, but I figured this would be a better... Ooh, girl, you best hurry. No! Get in the thing!
The camera changed on me. Fuck.
And you hurt your buddy.
Why you gotta say this again?
Run towards the screen, not away from.
But my buddy's back there.
Turn the camera. You wanna go in there. Oh no. Maybe it didn't see you because of the thing. If you had to switch bodies with one other round tabler, who would it be? Probably body Marcus. Well, Kevin, actually.
Kevin.
Yeah, Kevin. If you stop now, I think you dump back out at the beginning of the snow climb you've been doing.
Oh.
Run, go into there. There's a checkpoint after this crawl, I believe. Okay, cool. Over too, by the way, so you will have beaten this game the next time
really?
You sit down. Mm-hmm. It's a short game. It's about the journey. The short little journey. A lot of indie games are, you know, kind of on the shorter side. Yeah, he was saying there's like 20 minutes left of the game.
Of the entire game. Okay.
Yeah. Definitely getting this game for Kate. Fuck yeah, dude. Okay, you just hit the checkpoint. Alright, so it's up to you. Do you want to be done?
This is a save point?
Yeah, he said okay, you just hit the checkpoint.
Okay,
So, you can either finish it out or and go long, or we can be done. You want to be done?
I want to play Rocket League.
Alright, we're going to go play Rocket League, guys. Alright guys, thank you so much for joining us on Lexe Loves Game Night every Monday night from 9 to 11. It's been a real fucking pleasure. This was super fun.
I love this.
Yeah, so I feel bad for this, our buddy.
Oh, because
we're about
let's
to
finish.
Leave. Are you sure?
Yeah, let's finish.
Okay, we're gonna finish, guys.
I forgot that's a person.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Here. You play for a little bit. I played for the 2 hours, and then you get to experience it.
You have no cape.
I know.
Shit.
I need to answer my mom.
Okay, I will play for a little bit. All right, guys. We're not done. We're gonna crush this thing. Actually, especially if I can just kind of jump through some of this stuff real quick. I can't believe you have no cape. It's kind of cool though, I like that.
Yeah, because you know what? Sometimes you lose parts that you were born with. Like ligaments.
Well, also it's kind of like the hero's journey. You gain a bunch of strength and then you slowly it gets reduced and now you're just like crawling to the finish line.
Yeah.
I think that's a really cool kind of epic situation.
Exactly.
You want to turn down that, Lord Gold, I guess we're still going here. Is that we're about 20, 30 minutes out, so, you know, let's get there.
Thanks, sweetest.
Cool, it's the most beautiful ending in video game history. Whoops. Possible exception of FF9, this makes it very heavy. Awesome, glad we could, Dapiak. But you have to read the comments and answer them.
Hold on.
Man, I need to play FF9 again.
What's everybody's favorite Final Fantasy?
Oh, we've talked about this before. We've definitely done that, for sure. But yeah, if you want to list your favorite RPG, how about that? I do not play Black Ops 3. Just Overwatch. Right now I'm playing Overwatch. I'm doing a new game plus run in Dark Souls 3. Lexi and I are playing Super Mario Brothers U.
I love it.
And we just started playing co-op in Donkey Kong Tropical Freeze as well, which has been a lot of fun. We need to, like, I don't know how to get past this. Oh, did I die? Oh, no. Okay, you were supposed to do this. I was about to say, I was like, there's no dying in this game.
You know, I do have a lot of, like, spatial intelligence, but you would never know from the way that I play video games. I'm just like, I don't get it. What part of my brain is not working? Well,
I think there's a series of logic and tools that one gains from doing it
all
the fucking time, and I just think that that's really, at the end of the day, what it's about. Hmm. Favorite RPG? Morrowind. Never played it, which I did. Didn't get into the whole Bethesda thing until Skyrim. Favorite JRPG, FF9, honorable mention of Moonlight Sonata. Man, I want to play Moonlight Sonata.
What is Moonlight Sonata?
It's, you want to explain what it is, Dapiak? Let's do some co-op in Dark Souls 3, yeah. I love that.
Video game logic. Gotta learn that. Yeah. But, like, some people are... Yes.
Fuck yeah.
Thank you, Rita says we've got Ruckus.
Are we doing this after?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
I need to have a little fun. I've had a rough couple days.
Yeah, for sure.
So if any of you are friends on a friend of mine on Facebook, I lost a good friend yesterday. And, so it's been no fun to a very rare form of brain cancer.
Yeah, man. Like, really rough, really sudden, very young.
She was diagnosed 2 months ago. So, and it's just, and she's a newlywed, and, so it's been...
Why did he stop? Oh, okay. I was like, did he freeze to death?
I know. So, it's been rough. Not that, you know, it wouldn't be, but, you know. So we're trying to come up with a memorial sort of idea for what's
some of her friends. Moonlight Sonata.
I really want to play it. Yeah.
It's dying.
It's a JRPG about Chopin.
And you go with him on his death trip, and his music is the score, and the art is perfect. Oh my god, that sounds...
Yeah, I really want to check it out.
Amazing.
It was on my list. What is happening?
Turn around. Where is he? Flash your... There you go. Your,
It's not working.
Ah. Oh my god. Is this the end?
It's gotta be. So sorry, I lost a little brother to cancer. It's very horrible. We will. Speaking of which.
Yeah.
Make it. Hell yeah, Helms Levi.
Oh, that's terrible.
Every Monday, 9 to 11.
Yep. Is it taking you back through, like, where you were?
This feels new.
Okay.
Because it's icy, but... Tales of Destiny, best RPG ever. Maybe it's the ice version of...
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
I know.
No.
Oh, okay. You just go in there and then you can lift back up. Sorry, caps lock.
Okay, Helms. Yeah, see you Monday.
Fuck yeah.
Okay, it's Monday, absolutely. Cool. Oh my god. Nah.
I have to get back down here so I can, like.
You gotta get
re-up.
Here. Yeah.
Hopefully I'll be able to.
Get to the bridge, get to
I
the bridge, get to the
out
bridge,
of
get to the bridge.
Stuff
ah!
For it. Damn it. Oh, okay. There you go. Thank you.
Wow. Cool.
Next week will be probably Octodad.
Cool, yeah.
Maybe something else. Maybe a couple things, depending on... Yeah, I'll probably have a backup to Octodad in case it, like, wears out its welcome after, like, an hour.
Ooh.
kind of, it is definitely like taking you back through like
so cool,
a lot of the stuff you did and stuff at least. So fucking cool, this game. So glad I finally got the chance to play it. And this is like an HD kind of remake of it as well. I know that, so they definitely spiffied it up a little bit from its original version, yeah.
When did this come out?
Years ago.
Oh, really?
Yeah, a few years ago. It came out on PS3.
Oh.
And it won a ton of awards, and it was definitely hailed as... And it's always kind of hailed as one of those games that... It's one of those, arguments for, you know, games being art, you know, all that stuff. I love that her buddy's with us.
Anybody else?
I don't know, guys, does it look vaginal?
Upside down.
There's the body. I'm not sure why they stopped. Maybe technical issues? I don't know those things.
He just lends his.
I show up and I say terrible stuff, and I leave.
I need to go. I'll take this. Seriously, the music and I mean, I should shut up. It's so good.
It's fine. We are Twitch streaming. You can talk. Do you mind that I took over the controls?
No, it gives me a chance to, like, enjoy
hang
it
out,
more.
Yeah. I agree. That's kind of why I like just watching you.
Mm-hmm. Are y'all talking?
This morning.
Yeah. A friend of mine from high school is in that movie. It's probably garbage. Just saying.
Rapper. Yep, Dappy Egg, absolutely. fuck being a wrestler. I mean, some of it would be amazing, but... Yeah, The Rock has more money from being an actor.
Yeah.
Oh, and then they, like, ascend. All right, guys. That's Journey. So good, right? Did you enjoy your Sephiroth reward? There you go. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining us. And that was fun as shit. And I'm so glad we got to do this on stream with all you guys. Man, beautiful ending.
Yeah, my God.
Small dog in a landfill. Nothing could be happier than a small dog in a landfill. Yeah, for sure, Bjorn. This time we're actually gonna leave. Oh, hello! Alright, guys, I'm gonna go get another glass of wine. This was fantastic. Music composed by Austin Wintory. Good work, buddy. Alright, guys, take care. I'll see y'all next week. And good night.
That was really.